concentration the entire time.
Yeah, for me, the secret for this French outfit today in this quarterfinal in particular, they've got to make it a scrappy affair. They can't let Fiji get into the work, because if they do, Fiji, well, they've been super impressive with the amount of points they're in scoring, but have been very, very impressive with the way they've been able to defend it. Something they've really looked at this tournament, and man, oh man, they have looked real good.
Yeah, we talk so often about Fiji on attack and the razzle dazzle and the skill and the power and the pace, but their defence has been a real feature this weekend. France, got to keep their discipline though. They've been one of the most penalised teams heading into this weekend. Sitting sixth on the series are the French. And you look through them statistically, every stat they are near the top of the charts, yet somehow they have not made their way through to the upper reaches of the competition this season so far. Quarterfinal number one here at the HSBC Canada Sevens in Vancouver. It is Fiji against France for a place in the semi-finals. And we are off through the boot of Waisea Nafungu. And already knocked down on Fiji's side. Quickest to the loose ball is Fiji, and away they go through the skipper Dangunu. Lojelt can't get hands on him. Eventually it takes two French players to bring him to ground. Agua trying to get in there and disrupt Vakadina Billy. Big one-handed mitt to get this wide and wide early. And already some space and already the danger. Vanakovata the ball back in field. And off the kickoff, Waisea Nafungu puts Fiji in front.
Well, it doesn't take them long, does it? Less than 30 seconds to get the first score. But man, oh man, you look at this pass on the inside. My goodness gracious me, look at that, it just threads the needle, how good. Well, they just continue to amaze me the way they dish it up.
Well, always key would be starting well against them. Just when you think you've seen it all from Fiji, they put something out. France, worst possible start for them. Conversion is good too, Fiji. Go up early, 7 points to nil.
Oh yeah, up and loud. Right from the jump, the supporters, as always, in Fiji.
Drumming's been excellent. France rocked back early. Need to get hands on ball. Shallow with the restart, and that's really good work in the air by Lugel. And France through get around the outside. Get a chance with a little bit of ball, a little bit of possession to create. They've got some flyers of their own. In the hands of one of them now. Nelson Epe is losing his footing, and that allows Fiji to try and attack that ball on the ground. Can't do so though. Bom Didier clears away. Fiji France deep inside their own territory, but that's a nice wide ball for Ua to try and get a little room to move. Coming across and making the tackle was Thanakovata, and the penalty too. Great work from Elia Thanakovata. He was the man with the inside ball to Nafungu for the try, and now does his work on defense as well. And Davolo it was with the tap. Fiji looking to build, trying to get the arms free. Was Vakadina Billy. They know they have to keep those wrapped up. France look like they've blown through over the top of this. They've done really well, and they've got it quickly to their speedster. Epe, he has got speed to burn. Nelson Epe, they got the ball to him quickly, and then he did the rest with those fast feet round the outside. What a great response from France.
Well, I'll tell you what, it came from the breakdown work. Lojel was amongst it, the veteran from Le Bleu. They piled numbers into that area. They needed to get their ball because they were short if they didn't get it. See, they go shoot. The second one comes in, and the third one gives it out to Epe. I like the way he backed himself. Nathunga, you've got to remember, that guy's one of the fastest blokes on the circuit, and Epi gets France back into this one, very much against the run of play.
Now, quick heads up from Didier too, to know that that was where his strike weapon was, on the left, down the blind side. Just creeping up, there he is, 28 tries for the series. Considering we've still got a few tournaments to go, you think that record of Julien Hendelon might fall. So soon. Well taken off the restart by Fiji, of course. Looking to go width to width early. And some footwork as well. Inside ball can't connect from Lasaku, but there to tidy up Fiji again. And now straight at the middle. This could be dangerous. Tried to get the hands free, lost it down, but at a penalty. And a double blast.
Advantage is over, number two. Second deliberate knock on.
Yeah, who you are there. You've got to keep your discipline. You spoke about a pre-kickoff. That's where they've let themselves down, especially in these big matches.
It's number
deliberate
four.
Knockdown is the call. Number four, it's always going to be the case.
Number four.
Well, number four it was. They're just getting the right number.
No wonder. You see, Uat look so perplexed. It's Iragua who goes to the Sinman instead.
And this is when they're just so lethal. They're going to call a scrum here, which is a smart move by Fiji. Here's Iragua just getting his hands up. Yeah, that's fair enough. All the players know they can't do that. We've got to have a legitimate attempt to try and get that ball back, and he did it, and he pays the price.
Coach! Bind!
Shows how good Fiji have started this match. I'm just about to mention Jerry Tuai's name for the first time. Oh, free kick, though.
Early.
Well, Fakuruna Billy is saying they have actually pulled back the French there to get that penalty. He's been around a long time as Fakuruna Billy, and he saw that coming a mile off. The referee did it.
Riva taps on halfway for France. Down to six, and that's not going to help their cause either. It's hat to head, and now it's a foot race. France trying to get back as Epe, the speedster, who does well, but now play Fiji on. Just pile in ball, spills out the back four. France trying to be physical, but doing so illegally, trying to play on the ground, and Fiji have got numbers to burn. They are lining up out wide, and it's the captain, Davita Dongunu, who gets Fiji second of the quarterfinal.
Yeah, just lifting the tempo, aren't they? The Fijians, someone's down after that last ruck from Fiji. We can't see the number at the minute. France scrambling back. They take the quick tap. Always had numbers loaded. And the easiest of tries, and they take the full advantage of the miracle advantage that they have at the moment.
Kick is trying to come around, but stays wide. Try goes
unconverted. I'm gonna watch for it. I need you to hold your weight and don't go forward. I'll make sure they take the hit.
Yeah, the skipper just talking about that free that penalty from the scrum. It's fair enough. That's good from the skipper to beat the Dogungu.
Fiji was Nanduvalo who was down, but he is there. He's the one chasing this down. For Fiji, is France still a player short at the moment? Here's Epe, a little stutter step, and again he's got Nthongo on the outside. Oh, desperate from Fiji. It needed to be made. The ankle tap as Rebage is caught on the 10-meter line, and the ball spills clear. And here's broken play for Fiji over to work with. France may be stretched with just six on the field still. Wide they go early for Tanakavata. A penalty again, just getting piggybacked down the field at the moment. Fiji, Dongunu goes, and they look to spread through the right, and Rasaku can't get the ball back in field just yet for Nthongu, does so now. There's some big hits coming in from France. It's just disrupting the Fijians as well, but that always means there's going to be some space somewhere, especially with a little flick ball like that, and there's another knockdown, and more trouble coming for the French on the stroke of half-time. Gondini it is. Another knockdown, frustration, just as they were about to get the full complement back. They'll start the second half with a player short.
Number nine, blue, deliberate knock on.
Looks like for front, Igrahua has come back on because another player leaves. This is where they're so lethal, Fiji.
So, still only six. And there's the footwork of Nanduvalo. He's scored tries for fun since making his debut on the series a week ago. Rasaku. His step and weave and bob his way through and then gets the inside ball to the big man up the middle, and now they're just carving a track. Fiji just about breaks down and then pops the ball for who else but Vuivoa Nandavolo. He scored a try in every match he's played since making his
absolutely relentless, aren't they? Fiji, and here's the nice footwork initially. And numbers loaded. See the way they position themselves to receive that pass. Skipper keeping his head in the net. There's the last one off the deck. Nandu Volo puts an end to a good first 7 minutes for Fiji.
And the conversion as well. So Fiji will go to the break with a handy lead over France, 19 points to 7 in the first quarter final. So Iragua back out there for France, but still with one player in the sin bin. They drive this restart long, all the work ahead of the French, 19 points to 7. It's a good chop tackle around the ankles by Oliva. But the offloads are coming. That one doesn't stick, though. And here's some ball for France if they can make the most of it. Fiji trying to get in and disrupt again, and that'll be a penalty. Fiji players off their feet.
There was a number of French players, too. Two, in fact, Logel wanted to go quickly. They said they're going to slow it down. Remember, there's still a man down.
Not yet.
It's a good positive play. Instead of going to the line-out, they're going to try and back themselves with ball in hand.
Get Rondinier back shortly because there was time after that hooter in the first half, and that's a good ball, and oh, what a hand from the Thungu
to get
Rebaj
to
ground when open spaces were ahead of him, Riva. Now he gets the offload away. That's gone backwards for Uya, and the offload is good for him as well. That's Trubal onto the field, straight impact, straight away after the break for France. A timely score for the French.
Well, just remember, they've still only got six players on the field. Le Bleu at the moment, Travar, well, the offload, that was a nice line. That's the second time the Thungu saved them with an ankle tap. But in the end, the offload, the strength from Huya, who's been very good in this game, has given the French a little bit of a sniff.
Great conversion, too, from Pauline Riva to convert. Trouval's try, and Grandinier back out there now. So back to 7 France. Back to a 5-point margin. 19-14 Fiji lead. Fiji going to create and weave, and Nuthungu just manipulating this right side, looking for numbers, and all the hands are no good from Tuai. Which is something you really say. And just took a little knock on the way to ground.
Yeah, doesn't look good, does he, Jerry Tuai? That's outstanding work for him. He tries to batter it back. Just landed awkwardly on the release, but France, another opportunity at the right end of the field.
Wide they come for Trubal, one of the try scorers. They're getting it to their wide man quickly, looking to accelerate to the gate. And Grandinier on the wraparound. Has he got the footwork to get around? He does on Tuai. And France go bang, bang, straight after halftime. And they are right back in this quarterfinal.
Where they're finding a lot of success is out on the edge in the wings. They're getting their ball away. They're drawing in two defenders. Here's the strong one on the inside. They know they've got the centre looping around. And it's the second time that's worked for the French team, and Grandidier gets France on even terms.
For the lead, it's good, and France go ahead. 21 points to 19 in the quarterfinal, just under 4 minutes to play.
Massive, massive kickoff, this one here, this restart. Fiji desperately need their hands on the ball right now.
Restart is away. Lochelle gets backwards, up high, and it's gone backwards off. Initially, backwards off the French, and now Fiji arguing the point, and it's a knock on by Fiji. More ball for France.
Lochelle was the one that got up there, I think.
Time off
for the French.
Two blue. Substitution.
Well, they've been physical, this French team. That's the secret so far. Ben Gollings here in charge of this Fijian outfit, absolute legend of the game.
Time back on. Crouch. Bind. set.
In and out it goes from Mazzalini. Standing in midfield, Gunk Didier has been good since coming in off the sin bin. Now some big strong bodies in there too. Seffel. Lays it back for Mazzalini. France using their bench. Try and create an issue. Big, huge, wide ball, but the hands weren't there from Truebal. Probably looked up, saw some space. Couldn't haul it in.
You got to take that ball, have to in these moments. This is where I think Fiji are going to sting them. Ball was a little bit high.
Here we go.
Man.
That time they've been pulling.
That is a big miss.
I've got it.
Still having this argument here in the scrums, aren't they, Fiji? France are trying to pull out of a contact.
Stand up.
Pull out of the hit.
Both of you have to bind to the hooker. Thank you.
So watch out,
find it.
See how low the French are getting. They're trying to get underneath the Fiji and front rowers.
Bind. Set. Two stay in.
2 points in it. Just under 2 minutes to play. Tuai clears for Fiji. They haven't had hands on ball hardly at all in the second half. And now the danger in the footwork and the speed comes to the fore as well as Masaku looking to link up with Nufungu. Just taken down in a good tackle, and Gondini, has he stolen that back? Not quite for the French, but here come Fiji. Trying to go wide and wide quickly. They've got numbers if they need it, but they won't need them. And it's Jerry Tuai. Who else? When Fiji need a big play, it's their little wizard.
One mistake from France, and Fiji absolutely make them pay. This was a beautiful run. Unless you like the way he was composed. There, Asaku. Nathungu does well to keep their ball. Quick recycle, and when they need him most, it's their top shelf player, and Jerry Tuai coming up with the score to take the lead.
Took a couple of knocks. Vision is no good though, so it's not done. Stats, and still only 33. Could keep going for ages.
There's a CV if you want one. 55 tournaments, 135 tries, 2 gold medals in the back pocket. Jerry Tuai, one of the best ever.
Fiji by 3, 24-21. They go down to the 22 with the restart, and it's taken in by Mazzalini. Boucher on a 13. Truebal balls that one in. He's got one try, going to try and chop back in field and link up and be careful because man on. Good strength in the tackle from Seffel to stand, and now they've created a little bit of an overlap out here if they can make the most of it. Oh, Mazzalini, a player had cut back in field. He lost sight of Legel, and Legel hands on his, because as the siren goes, France's last chance goes out either the sideline as well, and Fiji with a late try will go through to the semi-finals, 24-21 over France.